Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for March the 21st of 2020, well, it is titled Comet ATLAS and the Mighty Galaxies. So what do we see here? Well, up in the upper left side, we see a comet, and we see the greenish glow that is associated with comets, and that occurs when carbon compounds are removed from their surface. So the nucleus of the comet, which would be completely invisible here, is allowing particles to leave from the energy of the sun, and some of those particles are carbon compounds, and carbon, when excited, gives off a greenish glow, much as we often see hydrogen giving off a red glow when it is excited. So we see that glowing material in the halo of the comet stretched around here. Now we can also see the tail of the comet stretching back, and that stretches back down towards the lower left-hand side. Not a very big tail at this time, but is expected to grow over time as this gets closer to the sun over the next 2 months. And this will actually get closer to the sun than Mercury, so has the potential to be a very nice comet and nicely visible in the evening skies. Now, comets are named after their discoverer. So who discovered this? Well, ATLAS actually is the Asteroid Terrestrial Impact Last Alert System, which is looking for asteroids that may impact the Earth. So attempt to give warning if a large asteroid were to be on impact with an impact collision course with the Earth. So it also will detect lots of other objects. Not everything that it detects will necessarily be on a collision course, but here we get to see a comet that this has also discovered. Now, in the lower right-hand side, we see two galaxies. There are two galaxies there. Those are known by their catalog designations, M81 and M82. And these are spiral galaxies, and we can see the distinct spiral structure in M81, which is we're looking at more face on, and the other one, M82, is a much more flattened disk. We're seeing that one edge on, so we're seeing it, the flattened portion of it. Now, these galaxies are, of course, much, much further away than the comet. The comet is within our own solar system. The galaxies that we see are many millions of light years away. So much, much further away off in the distance. And, of course, just seem to be close to the comet in the sky because that happens to be their location. So it does not really have anything to do with being close together in space, as we lose that three-dimensional aspect when we look out into the sky. We cannot see directly what things are closer and what things are further away. So what we see here is the nearby comet. We see many stars within our own Milky Way that are further away than the comet. And then we see many galaxies that are much, much further away than the stars. So stars may be hundreds or thousands of light years away. The galaxies can be many millions of light years away. And we do see a few more galaxies. Actually, if you look around the image, you will see more galaxies than just the two that we've mentioned here in the lower right-hand corner. So that was our picture of the day for March the 21st of 2020. It was titled Comet ATLAS and the Mighty Galaxies. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Moon Down. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.